We started StepUp.one nearly 2 years ago, reskilling refugees and connecting them to opportunities that pay. Fundamentally, one of the principles that we are working on is that learning and earning has to be connected at the hip. We started this when Mohammad Hassan, sitting next to Satya Nadella, challenged that when capital, goods, and money move so freely across the world, why is that 196,000 refugees are stuck in a camp for more than 20 years? His mother came to the camp nearly 40 years ago, and he was born in the camp, and he has never stepped out of the camp. And this is the first time he has come to the World Economic Forum or to any place. So he said, instead of money and aid, which is definitely a great thing, is it possible for you guys to, help us get access to a marketable skill and connect us to global opportunities with which we can make our own livelihood? This was the challenge that he threw on the World Economic Forum in Davos at 2019, around January. So I got really, inspired by this simple yet a very big challenge. And we reached out to the Kukuma refugee camp, UNHCR officials, and offered to give both a marketable skill and access to opportunities. We decided to reskilling the refugees on social media marketing. The two things, right? One, the number of jobs available for social media marketing is, extensive and global. And two, you can execute these jobs from anywhere in the world. You don't have to be in any place. As long as you have a mobile phone or a laptop and some internet connection, which one of the reports said that the Kakuma refugee camp has in plenty, more than 60% of the refugees in Kakuma refugee camp had access to a smartphone. So that really gave me the hope that we could do something big on social media marketing. When we searched for the job social media marketing in both Upwork.com and Fiverr.com, we had more than, 30,000 jobs available at that very specific point in time. So we said the number of jobs is really big, the idea is really good. And more than that, the refugees will also know how to amplify their own voice if they need that. We anonymously deciding that we will go with social media marketing. These are the leaders that we reached out to from UNHCR. They all loved the idea. We selected five refugees to be our pilot team, and we designed and executed a simple step-by-step plan to teach them social media marketing. We also handpicked the tools used by the top design agencies all over the world, so that when we deliver an outcome for our client, the quality of our outcome doesn't look like any different than if it would have been designed by the top agency in London or New York or Sydney. We picked Hootsuite, we picked Lumen, we picked Zapier, we picked ClickUp, and we picked Canva. These are the top five tools that we use in order to deliver the impact for our social media work. We also trained our graduates to use the right social media platform. They already knew about many of these platforms, but what they did not know is what platform to use for what client, right? Because every client, say for example, one of our clients is a president of a large educational software company, and for him, there is no point in doing anything on Facebook or Instagram. He needs to use LinkedIn to reach all the potential buyers of his educational adaptive learning software. It's important we only choose LinkedIn, and we work with him only on LinkedIn. We don't work with him on any other platform. Similarly, another client of ours, she's in the coffee business, and she needs to talk to every coffee lover that's out there. So of course, we don't go to LinkedIn and search for all the people who love coffee. We do that on Facebook. We trained our graduates to use the right platform to deliver the right impact for every individual client that hired our graduates. So that's our second thing. And the third thing is we wanted our graduates to follow a simple step-by-step process, which can be followed by anybody. If there is a good recipe, anyone should be able to cook it. Some of them may be really top talent, and some of them could be average, but we don't really care. We want everybody to be able to follow a step-by-step process and deliver the same impact to our client who actually hire us. So we follow this six-step process. I have more detailed things on that. But basically, what it is we baseline our client, where does he stand in the social media? Then we determine the influencers that he needs to influence or he needs to get influence. We connect with the right audience that he needs to either, sell to, or he needs to have a standing amongst. That's the audience. And then we start with simple liking the things or connecting on LinkedIn, and so on and so forth. then we start sharing, etc., etc. Then we go to commenting and tagging. And finally, we start creating point of views, videos, and literally stories that we can tell visually. We have done, and this has been the biggest success for us, creating videos for our clients in the last 16 months or so that we've been working for our clients. So we proved and expanded these skills so far by providing paid social media services to more than 10 clients over the last, I would say, 12 months for all of them. But the first one started nearly 16 months ago. So we have right now, every one of our refugees have one job at least. Some of them have more than three jobs.
That's nice.
And then this is an appeal where we are saying now that they are ready, we'll step up by giving them an opportunity.
Okay.
And what is an opportunity? What we are saying is that you can employ one of our graduates as your social media manager for $100 a month. Right. And what? How does it work? We take our client's input, our client's objective. Some people want to be a thought leader. One of the guys who's aspiring to be a doctorate, he wants to be known amongst all the same kind of people as a thought leader. He doesn't want to sell anything. He wants to be known as a thought leader. There is one more person, another client, all he wants is to sell a service. He has a service and he wants that service to be sold to thousands and thousands of potential buyers.
Yeah. So
many times our clients' objectives could be two different things, or they can be both. One person say, I want to be a thought leader on Twitter, and I want to sell my adaptive learning software on LinkedIn. So that's the input we get. And then we execute the six steps I just told you. That's action our refugees, our refugee graduates, you know, do on the right social media platform. And the output is things like this. We have done more than 2,000 LinkedIn connections for one of our clients. We have sent, you know, more than 4,000 LinkedIn outreach messages for one of my clients. And what kind of outcome comes because of that? We create a pipeline of deals, or if the person is trying to sell something, or if the person is trying to be a thought leader, a solid engagement on his videos, on his post, etc., etc., by the people that he respect. So that so the outcomes that we try to, you know, drive. And the impact of doing all these things is, every one of our client, their personal brand has grown 10 times, 100 times, right?
Okay.
We are not trying to brand their company. We are trying to brand them as a person. They have seen increase in revenue. Some of them have got huge jump from one job to another and the right recognition in the right circles. So it's worked out brilliantly for the five who we have got now.
Okay.
So this is a little bit more expansion of each one of those steps. I don't want to go into the details, but fundamentally for each step, we have a software and we have a deliverable. The step one, baseline, determine influencers, identify audience. Just have a look at it. We have already discussed this. But what I'm saying is there is enormous depth behind each of these steps. It's not just some simple thing, right? And this is what we teach our graduates, so that if anybody can follow these six steps, as if it was a prescription from their doctor, right, they can deliver the outcome. So we provide the training, we provide the software, we provide the, you know, mentorship, so that, you know, anybody, regardless of their individual capacity, can deliver as if they're working for a top design agency in anywhere, you know, in the world. We also got an amazing break when Hootsuite gave their state-of-the-art social media platform for free to us, to all our graduates to use. We have another one is, we have also partnered, it is still work in progress, Chingala, so that we can tackle the last mile infrastructure, you know, to deliver the Wi-Fi boxes to all the, you know, camps that we are going to be working with, because Wi-Fi boxes are very important. We try to scale from the current 5 to 500 to 5,000. So just a recent picture of these four guys having worked for paying clients for more than 12 months. There is definitely a huge, just give me one second, but there is a huge spring in their steps. We love it, right? But that's the story, right? If you have any questions, you can ask me. But what I want to do in the next 5 to 10 minutes is to bring you into the, what do you say? Bring you into the vision, or what is the economic that we are, what is our vision? Why are we doing this?
And before we proceed, are you only training them on social media, only social media marketing? You don't offer other courses?
Like what?
Apart from social media, maybe, what can I, photography, something like that.
So look, pretty much all of them are sub-modules. One of my guys is training on photography. My graduates is trying to do video editing. So I don't want to call like thousands of things. So there is only one thing which actually produces the outcome, which is social media marketing, social media selling.
Because now when I'm writing an article, I want to profile if it's maybe they're only able to do social media. So that's the main thing that they do.
See, they will do one thing that is going to get them livelihood or money. Right?
Yeah.
And that one thing is creating a social media impact for their clients. And for doing that, they need to write good content. They need to shoot great photographs. They need to create amazing videos. They need to edit good stories. So they've done all of those things. Once they are able to see what impact that they're creating and the money that they're earning, everything becomes really secondary. Yeah. So I don't want to say we are teaching them 20 things. We are only teaching them one thing. But the good news about that one thing is because it is digital marketing, it has it is not just one thing. It is 200 things. But the good thing is there is only one thing that gets them their money, the impact that they make on social media on behalf of their clients. In order to make a bigger and bigger impact, they need to become better and better photographers, video editors, designers, logo. But I do not want to say that we are training them on 200 things. We are only training them on one thing, how to use social media to create huge impact for the clients. Because when we started, there was many great ideas. Let's teach them translation, right? Because they know, each of them know more than five languages. Let's do, you know, this and that. There were many ideas, right? I just said, look, we're going to focus on one idea and we're going to make it work and we're going to make them get paid. Because, you know, if we say we're doing some 20 things and then none of that will actually not deliver the real results.
Yeah. Right?
So why StepUp.1? We believe access to reskilling and opportunity should be available to everyone, refugee or not. We believe learning and earning must be connected, right? At the hip, we believe the world is getting digitized. To train somebody on a particular skill is not that difficult because, you know, that we can digitize the entire training and give it to them. That's what we're doing right now. We can also access global opportunities that the gig economies are, you know, producing every single day. So we can actually give them the jobs, give them access to those jobs. We also believe that the ability to execute these jobs anytime, anywhere, right? Whether they're inside the camp, outside the camp, flying high somewhere else, the ability to execute these jobs anytime, anywhere, any place is the single biggest thing that is working for us, right? And that's amazing to see those actions. And finally, we believe equipping these refugees with social media skills not only gives them livelihood, but also an amplified voice. Right?
Okay.
Voice that they can amplify for a cause that they choose to amplify. It is not just money, or importantly, over a period of time, a voice. I believe, you know, many times more important than the money. But we want to start with livelihood. So that's the thing. But so why are we doing this? What is our vision? Our vision is to create a scaled, self-sustaining economic engine within the Kakuma refugee camp, right? First, we don't want to be running everywhere and trying to do everything. We want to make a scalable, self-sustainable economic engine within the camp before we replicate it across the 70 million refugees across all other camps. And here is a very simple example of what are the resources we need to do that. What activities we need to do that to do, you know, in order to make it happen. And what outputs we are expecting these activities to produce. And then what outcomes will come out of it. And what is the impact? I will leave you to, you know, have a broad look at it. But fundamentally, we are trying to create a $30 million economy within Kakuma in 3 years. And we believe we can do that by bringing in $6 million of revenue, get multiplied at least five times when the money gets spent from the barber shop, to the rice shop, to the meat shop, you know, on the local economy that is out there in Kakuma.
Yeah.
We also think, more importantly, like I said, we can empower them with a big voice. I think that's really important. That's our big vision. And how do we plan to get to the 6 million mark by the end of 2022? Beginning of 2023, we start with around two teams and 10 refugees right now. And our plan is to reach the 500 mark. In fact, our immediate next step is 500 refugees. That's what, you know, we are doing right now. We are creating 10 team leaders who would each have a team of 50 people to work with. So that it is easy for each leader to control a team of 50 and then work for 50 or 100 clients, each of them. Mini leadership modules are so that each of them can scale, almost train the trainer rather than going and training all 5,000 refugees. It'll be a mess.
Yeah.
We just train 10 refugee leaders who will then train 10 more below them who will then train. So it'll be a very close-knit family of teams to deliver this mark. And we expect that to reach the 6 million mark by the end of fiscal 2022 by having 5,000 refugees working across 100 teams, 500,000 per month, which if you multiply should give you 6 million a year.
Just a minute. So you talked about 70 million refugees. So these are the working age or all the refugees
in the world.
Oh, in the world. So you want to reach out to 70 million refugees in the world.
Yes, but we don't want to do that as of yet. And we always want to finish all the camps first. We want to, especially the camps supported by UNHCR or IOM. We think we have made a very good start in Kakuma refugee camp. So everything that I've said so far is only for Kakuma refugee camp. We've just started the next refugee camp, the Kutupalang refugee camp in Cox's Bazar, Bangladesh, the world's largest refugee camp. We will be very slow in starting too many before we make Kakuma a huge success. Because it's easy to just spread and but we want to create a golden template in Kakuma that can be taken, replicated in every camp that is managed by UNHCR or any other, organization, right? So that's our big aim. But we don't want to think, let's go to all 70 million and lose the, basic thing. We believe we have made a difference to the 5 people in the last 2 years. For us, that itself is, we have achieved our, ambition. We have changed the lives of 5 people forever. But if we can change the life of 5,000 people in Kakuma, we believe, it's not just the 5,000 people whose life we will change, but probably the 50,000 people who depend on these 5,000 and their families, and even the 100,000 people who further work with them. And it's just the entire economy will thrive if we are able to bring the net new $6 million into Kakuma through this work. Because even now, the majority of the money that Kakuma is getting is in the form of aid. But that converts into something that they have earned. We are talking about giving them hope and dignity. $6 million will multiply many times to make the economy work so much more better. There is some math behind all these things as to how we are going to do it. But the point I was making before is our plan is to have a structure. It is one thing to have a strategy, but if you do not have a good structure, a good foundation to support it, you will just fail it will not be self-sustaining. So we want to have one company with 10 leaders, group leaders, with 100 leaders, below them, 5,000 refugees working for them. And all of these things, the company, the leaders, the team leaders, and the refugees, all will be within the Kakuma camp. That's our ambition. So that the camp itself will be a self-sustaining engine without any injection from outside. This is some kind of a mathematics. So in summary, we want this model to scale and sustain by itself, not just financially, though we have only talked about finance so much, but right across the spectrum, their ability to create relationship capital, their intellectual capital, every one of these capitals, not just the money aspect of it. The money is definitely the one that we are, aiming at, but we believe we can have an impact on every one of these, things. Of course, this is our final slide, not just in Kakuma, right across all refugee camps. The caveat is one camp at a time. We don't want to rush and try to chew more than we can swallow. And that's pretty much it from my side. There is another set of slides, which is about scaling and stuff like that. I don't want to go into that. Right now, I can just quickly, I can show you at a very high level how we are going to. So we split our work into 4 parts: onboarding, training, finding jobs, and executing jobs. So then we split each one into 4 more steps. What is onboarding? Onboarding is identifying our graduates in the camps. Then assessing our graduates to determine their current skill level. both physical skills and digital skills and emotional skills across the spectrum? Where do they stand today? Getting them infrastructure, laptops, mobile phones, charging, Wi-Fi and internet. And then also getting them safe space and then time and then the ability to travel to that safe space. So these are the four important things that is needed in order to, you know, onboard hundreds and thousands of people. We need to scale each of these steps in order to, you know, really make a difference. And then training, training to you, all of these, you know, training the basic 101, training the tools, training the platforms, training our framework that we have created will all be digital. Therefore, they can be scaled at will. If these videos can be seen by 5 people, it can be seen by 5 million people. There is no problem in how these videos, thanks to YouTube, millions and millions of people can learn from simple platforms like YouTube. Finding jobs will be the most difficult thing for us. We have thought very critically how to scale this. Mm-hmm. It's easy to find 5 jobs, 10 jobs, 50 jobs. Mm-hmm. But how do you find 500 jobs? How do you find 5 million jobs? However great our work is, what we are doing right now is creating an infrastructure. We are creating a team, a sales team, country by country. We will have a sales team for Kenya. We'll have a sales team for South Africa. We'll have a sales team for Australia. Then we are developing end-to-end sales collaterals. For example, if you are in Australia, who are the top 1,000 executives that you want to send the idea to? So we provide them that list. Then we help you execute the step-by-step sales process. We help you email the executives. We help you talk to them on LinkedIn, right? So that each country team is able to talk in their own country and bring on, you know, clients. So the country teams will then close the process of selling the idea by signing the deal and having the first meeting with the refugee who's going to, the graduate refugee who's going to actually do the work for the client. And finally, we realized that's not enough. Our graduates need enormous amount of help while actually doing it. Because we have given the freedom to our clients. If any of our clients don't like the outcome that they are getting, they can simply cancel the job. So the good news is we have had clients working with us for more than 12 months and they love it every single month. It just keeps getting better and better. We are able to continuously learn and continuously help our graduates to keep on moving and moving, right? We are also creating the team to do this in order to help them execute the jobs. But unlike our country teams, which is going to be finding the jobs, teams for executing the jobs will be all based within the Kakuma refugee camp.
Okay.
Because we believe that mentorship has to happen inside the camp, and that's when it is much more effective. So we are training people to actually, you know, mentor the people while they are actually delivering the results for the thing, which is why our structure is there. Then there is a lot of details behind this, Liz, you know, I don't want to go into that, but basically, what do we need for onboarding, right? What do we need for training? What do we need for finding jobs? How many? So each of that is very fully detailed so that everybody knows exactly where we are, how to get there, et cetera, et cetera. So that's our overarching story of who we are, our story, our vision, and how we plan to scale from 5 to 500. 5 to 500 is our next milestone.
How do you identify, do you advertise, or how do you identify these refugees?
Currently, the UNHCR head of education is helping us identify the people in the Kakuma refugee camp. As long as you have a refugee status and if you live within the Kakuma refugee camp, you should be able to simply apply and become a part of a team, basically.